Okay guys, I'm back with Repton again, is it? Because I really don't think I did this game justice in the last video. Like I said, this was a game I first played in the 80s. Well, I'm saying this, guys, you really should give it a look. Bit disappointed my first video didn't get I was hoping for. But what I wanted to concentrate on today was the accessibility of this game. As you can see here, I've got the two button on each side layout. As you can just see here, these buttons here. And then if we pause it and if we go to settings, not only can you move the button location, let's see if that works. See if it does anything. I'm not sure it would actually. Yep. Let's move the buttons down to the bottom of the screen. So you can move the buttons around anyway. So that's the button configuration. Next, we'll go to gesture. And this changes to a sensitivity. So we'll go back. So this means if you resume, you just move your finger around. Up there, maybe. Come on. And then you move your finger around where you want it to go. And again, you can change the sensitivity of that. So we go to settings again. Change sensitivity down. Back, resume, just gives you a little more control if you need it. See, the little guy literally just following my finger. I think it's him that's actually called Repton. And then if we go to the final control settings, which I think is my favourite, it's D-pad. And again, you can change the location. As you can see, you've got four buttons here. That just gives you full control. I just think it's brilliant. So it makes the game accessible to everyone. Play it two-handed. Change the pressure. So if someone's got severe mobility problems, they can still access this game. Whether they have a disability or whether you want to introduce this game to a youngster that's getting used to the iPad for the first time. Or games on the iPad for the first time. All suitable, all brilliant. Now, next thing I want to show you is you can change the graphics. We go to settings again, and we go retro graphics, go back. Resume. Look at their graphics. They really, really bring back memories of when I was playing this game on the BBC Micro. Once again, the developers have done an amazing job on this game. Can't wait to play more. Please if you like these kind of games, give it a try. It really is a good game, as I'm looking around to see where my final gems are, because I'm obviously missing some. Let's have a look. There they are. Done it. Oh, I can't get over these retro graphics. Amazing. Right, you gotta watch out for that egg, so don't hatch it. What you need to do is move these two. That one. Then go the other side. Oh no, don't go down too far. Thanks. I can't squash it. I thought you could squash it. Oh no. Well, that's alright. We can, we can do that. Oh no, we can't. I've done that wrong. Oh no. Help. I can't believe I've done that. Oh well, I'm trying to get him at the top now. Right, it's not the end of the world. What we've got to do first, we go around here. We need to move that egg along. That egg needs to be here, if we can help it. But I don't think we can. Right, okay, hang on. How are we gonna do this? Move. Oh no. Died. Anyway, I think this covers everything I wanted to talk about. The game is accessible, you can have retro, you can have the new graphics. Just taking out that button there. Put the new graphics back where you've got to get keys, makes it a bit more to it. I just think it's brilliant. Please go and check it out, guys. It's amazing. And that's all I've got to say in it. Please check out these videos, guys. I was a bit disappointed that my first one hasn't had any views. Like I say, I hope this series moves on as I bring more and more games into it. Let me know if there's any retro games you want me to check out. Leave it in the comments below, and I'll see you all soon. Bye for now.